Not very talkative, our new resident.
Damn surly, if you ask me. Only just about managed to say good evening.
Yeah, my move, I think.
Yes.
Dreadful business, this Dr. Heidecker getting his head locked off.
The world's full of maniacs. Ever crossed your mind that you never know who you're standing next to in the street?
Funny you should say that. Today, I stood next to probably the worst madman of the decade.
Who?
Dr. Frederick Brandt. Remember him?
Yes, I do. But where did you see him? Not in the street, surely?
Well, of course not. I had to call at the asylum today to discuss a new plumbing installation. I passed him in the exercise yard.
Name rings a bell, but I can't place it.
Well, he's a doctor who caused an absolute furore in the medical world about 5 years ago with some fantastic and devilish notion he had about transplanting people's brains. You know, putting them from one person into another. And he claimed that anyone undergoing such surgery could survive. Absolute claptrap.
I seem to recall that another fellow had the same idea at the same time. The foreigner. Oh dear. What was his name now?
Frankenstein. Baron Frankenstein. Lived in Bohemia.
That's the one. They were both run out of the medical profession, weren't they?
That's right. And Frankenstein was run out of his country as well. Mm. The church in particular pilloried him. The devil's disciples, the pair of them. Of course, if it was the work that Brandt was engaged on that sent him mad, you know. Well, it must have been.
Excuse me. I didn't know that you were doctors.
Doctors? We are not doctors.
I beg your pardon. I thought you knew what you were talking about.
You're damn rude, sir.
I'm afraid that stupidity always brings out the worst in me.
Stupidity?
Yes, stupidity. It is fools like you who have blocked progress throughout the ages. You make pronouncements on half facts that you don't understand anyway.
I find your tone and manner highly objectionable, sir. But if you wish to involve yourself in an argument about it, pray, explain the word progress in this context.
You wouldn't understand it. But I will give you a parallel that you may just appreciate. Had man not been given to invention and experiment, then tonight, sir, you would have eaten your dinner in a cave. You would have strewn the bones about the floor, and then wiped your fingers on a coat of animal skin. In fact, your lapels do look somewhat greasy. Good night.